In our previous video, we learned about the first principles. Today, we will be using that knowledge to find the derivative of this theorem. This is the first theorem in differentiation. The derivative of x to the power n is equal to n into x to the power n minus 1. So let's take this example. Here we have f of x equals x to the power 5. Instead of using the first principles to solve this, we can use this theorem to easily find the answer. The answer will be 5 into x to the power 5 minus 1, that is equal to 5 into x to the power 4. We can do this for negative numbers also. So here if we have f of x is equal to x to the power minus 2, the derivative can be found as minus 2 into x to the power minus 2 minus 1, that is minus 3. So that's how we use this theorem to find the derivative of x to the power n. So now for the proof of this theorem. Here we take f of x is equal to x to the power n as our first equation. Like we learned in our previous video, we can take f of x plus delta x is equal to x plus delta x whole thing to the power n. This will be our second equation. Then we have to mention where delta x is an increment of x. Now we subtract equation 1 from equation 2. So that gives us f of x plus delta x minus f of x is equal to x plus delta x whole thing to the power n minus x to the power n. Now we need to expand this using the binomial theorem. Here we will be using a simpler version of the binomial theorem to make our calculations easier. Many people try to memorize this expansion. In math, you don't have to memorize anything. I have an easier method to remember this expansion. So for the expansion of x plus delta x whole thing to the power n, first what you have to do is you take x into delta x for all the terms. So we have x into delta x plus x into delta x plus x into delta x, so on until the last term. The first x will have the power n, then the second will have n minus 1, and this will continue with every consecutive term having 1 less than the previous term. So this will be x to the power n minus 2 and so on until the last term will have x to the power 0. So basically that is 1. Now that we have the power of x, for the power of delta x, we start with 0. So the first term will have delta x to the power 0. The second term will have delta x to the power 1. And so on, it keeps on increasing until the last term will have delta x to the power n. Now that we have the powers of both x and delta x, we now need to find the coefficient. So the first term's coefficient will always be 1, and also the last term will also have 1 as the coefficient. After that, the next term will have n as the coefficient. Then after that, for the other coefficients, since we are going with a simpler version, we can label them as constants, nu, lambda, or any other character. So this is the final expansion of x plus delta x whole thing to the power n. Now we substitute this in our equation here. So f of x plus delta x minus f of x is equal to x to the power n plus n into x to the power n minus 1 into delta x plus nu into x to the power n minus 2 into delta x squared, and so on until we have the last two terms as lambda into x into delta x to the power n minus 1 plus delta x to the power n, and this minus x to the power n comes from this equation here. Then for our next step, we have to divide both sides by delta x. So every term here has to be divided by delta x. So the first term will have n into x to the power n minus 1. Second term will have nu into x to the power n minus 2 into delta x. And so on until the last term will have delta x to the power n minus 1. Finally, we will have to apply limits to both sides. So limit of f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x, as delta x tends to 0, is equal to limit of this whole thing as delta x tends to 0. If you look at this whole thing, you can see that only the first term does not have a delta x. All the other terms has a delta x in them. So when we use direct substitution, all of these terms will tend to 0. Only this first term will remain. So the derivative of f of x will be equal to n into x to the power n minus 1. So that is the proof of this theorem. So now for the tip of the day. I had a bonus question in my previous video. I asked to find the derivative of f of x equals 7. So this is the calculation for that. So we get f of x plus delta x will also be equal to 7. So when we minus f of x plus delta x minus f of x, we get 0. So when we apply the limit, we can find the final derivative of f of x will be equal to 0. So remember, the derivative of a constant is always 0. If you look at this diagram here, you can see that the gradient of this line is 0 since it is a constant and parallel to the x-axis. So that brings us to the end of this video. We have many exercises for you in the description below to familiarize yourself with today's topic. The answers are also given for your reference. Until we meet again, take care.